to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted of God in the time of man's innocency, signifying unto us the mystical union that exists between Christ and his church. This holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence and first miracle he wrought in Cana of Galilee, St. Paul commended as being honorable among all men. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these persons' presence now come to be joined. The congregation will be seated at this time. Cobol, Joseph, and Colleen Teasley, I require and charge you, both as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that a commitment to marriage is a commitment to permanence. It is the intent of God that your marriage will be for life, and that only death will separate you. If the vows you exchange today be kept without violation, and if you seek always to know and do the will of God, your life will be blessed with his presence, and your home will abide in peace. Can you just please each other this time? That's for me the best man. I come very close to one. Will you have this woman to be your wedding wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her so long as you both shall live? If so, respond, I do. Did you all hear that?
No.
Okay. After four, three, four.
I do.
Very good. Yeah. Early Tuesday. Will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love, honor, and keep him in sickness and health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him so long as you both shall live? If so, respond, I do. Okay.
We can't hear.
But by popular demand, we want to hear if you are good.
I do.
Okay, a little bit.
Better.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Who gives this man to be married to this woman?
I do.
I didn't even have a mic. But we all is there. Give him a round of applause at this time. Okay.
According to God's holy ordinance,
I pledge my faith.
I pledge my faith.
I pray take you over to be my wedding husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance. And thereto I pledge you my faith. Okay, you understand me? Ask the ring.
Oh my gosh, she wants attention. She wants a mom. She's boy.
Let us pray. Father, we thank you for these rings. These rings, Lord, which symbolizes the mystical union between Christ, the church, Lord, and married Father. Lord, and we lift these rings before you. We pray that you would bless them. Lord, we pray that as they would wear Kilborn and Khalil would wear this ring, oh God, they would wear it with love, with honor, with respect, with dignity, oh God. Father, we pray that, Lord, at no time will they take it off their hands and cast it aside in vexation and anger. But Lord, they would wear it, oh God, at all times, oh God. Not to be picked up later, oh God. But we pray that you would bless them, Lord, you protect it, and Lord, you would keep it safe, Lord. Bless these rings, Father, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Okay.
It was nails. Mm-hmm. Bro, that was a nice.
She got that.
Thing. Wow. It's pretty.
This ring.
I give you. As a love.
As a love.
And a token.
And a token.
Of my constant.
Fidelity.
The rings are pretty too.
Strong, I love you.
Even better pictures.
Lord, they have chosen this evening to do what is right before you. What is right and pleasing in your sight. Let us come into your house and stand before your man servant. And Lord, do what your word has commanded them to do. Father, today, in the name of Jesus, we pray your blessings upon their lives. Father, in this hour, Lord, we come against every plan that the enemy has, Lord, directed towards this marriage. Lord, we frustrate them right now in the name of Jesus. And Father, we denounce the works of darkness, oh God. Lord, we stand against every principality, every demonic influence that will try to infiltrate and disrupt. But Lord, you have joined together this evening, oh God. Lord, sprinkle your blood upon them today, Father. Lord, and let, Lord, your name be glorified in this marriage, in this union. Father, today, oh God, we come against generational curse. We come against those things that are in the bloodline, oh God. We come against and we break them today in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we Lord, we take authority over them, Lord. And we pray that, Lord, you will bless them today, Father. Cause them to prosper, Lord God. Give them the skills that are necessary, Lord, to lead this family, oh God. And oh Lord, God, their children, oh God. We pray that you will bless and you will keep them. Lord, we come against the spirit of separation. We come against the spirit of envy. We come against, oh God, every malicious spirit right now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we pronounce your blessings upon them today, Father. Keep them in your presence. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 I think that this time we lost our chief bride. This is the part where everybody looks for. More than the bride and the groom. Alright? So. For as much as this man and woman have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and have declared the same by joining of hands, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, Let no man put asunder. Right? We're going to ask now to remove her veil. I want just want to do something just to make sure. Remove her veil on her face. We said, we didn't say put the dress on his face.
Blessing in abundance.